People my age read newspapers, print. They don't read social media very much. But I think there's obviously a very large shift in the reading habits of young people, away from print and toward the web, and away from blogs toward tweeting, and so that the length has changed, you know, the attention span of readers is shrinking. And I don't know what effect that's going to have. I mean, maybe it'll just be like, you know, 100-word stories from now on. It's hard to tell. The change is happening so rapidly, though, I don't know the answer to that question. I think there are two big changes. Probably the major change is the availability, the growing availability of information on the internet, so that there's a lot more computer-assisted reporting used and databases used as a basis rather than human interviewing and digging. There are two kinds. One is kind of like fake investigations in the sense that they're very shallow. You know, they pretend to be investigations, but they're really not really very deep. And then there are now also, with the loss of financial stability for newspapers, there's been a growth of NGOs that do only investigations and give the material to newspapers or TV stations. I noticed that some people are experimenting with sort of a mass investigation in the sense that, for instance, last week they released, or earlier this week they released something like 20,000, 30,000 emails by Sarah Palin when she was the governor. And some newspapers, like the New York Times and the Washington Post, appealed to their readers. They put it online, and it was thousands of pages, and they appealed to readers to look through it and send in what they found, look through little things. And so they had 100 people looking for stuff.
Okay.
It was kind of a cooperative effort. That didn't exist before that way. That's created a huge ethical debate. WikiLeaks, because, you know, if you look at Watergate, a real abuse was taking place. It's unclear whether there was an abuse here or not. I mean, many of the emails, that, at least in the United States, that came out in WikiLeaks, actually showed that the government was doing a good job. It was surprising. I mean, many of them were emails from State Department officials and embassies around the world. And in fact, turned out to be much more sophisticated and astute than we had imagined. So it didn't really reveal an abuse in that sense. There were a few.